Good day, everyone. I'm Nina Marie Vinalay from BSN 2B, and the assigned topic to me that I'm going to share with you is all about teaching reading comprehension. First, what is reading again? Reading is a complex task which involves both decoding and comprehending the text. So it means to be a good reader, you may be able to do both of these, the decoding and comprehending the text without much thought or effort. They may use strategies to help them. Next, what is reading comprehension? Reading comprehension is the ability to process text, understand its meaning, and to integrate with what the reader already knows. In short, it is the ability of one person to understand information presented in written form. Like, for example, in fiction books, children imagine the characters and share an emotional and adventurous journey with them. In nonfiction books, children gain new information which deepens their understanding of new topics and concepts. Reading comprehension is a complex skill that requires time and practice to develop fully. Next, we have here the types of reading. One of the first things you learn about teaching is that there are different reading techniques, and the student should be aware of which technique is most suited, depending on the reading tasks required by the text or by their teacher. Training students to know the different reading techniques and when to use them is very important, especially under exam conditions when time constraints come into play and students need to have faster reading, learning, and memory skills. So the four main types of reading techniques are the following. We have here skimming, scanning, extensive reading, and intensive reading. In skimming sometimes referred to as a gist reading, means going through the text to grasp the main idea. Here the reader doesn't pronounce each and every word of the text but focuses their attention on the main theme or the core of the text. For example of skimming are reading magazines or newspapers and searching for a name in a telephone directory. Next is scanning. Here the reader quickly scuttles across sentences to get to a particular piece of information. Scanning involves the technique of rejection or rejecting or ignoring irrelevant information from the text to locate a specific piece of information. Next we have here is intensive reading. Intensive reading is far more time-consuming than skimming and scanning as it needs the reader's attention to detail. It involves close reading that aims at the accuracy of comprehension. Here, the reader has to understand the meaning of each and every word. So next is the extensive reading. Extensive reading lays more emphasis on fluency and less on accuracy. It usually involves reading for pleasure and is more of an out-of-classroom activity. It is highly unlikely for readers to take up the extensive reading of text they do not like. Let's move on to the reading comprehension skills. We have here the six reading comprehension skills, which is the vocabulary, reflection, summarization, supporting claims, fast check, and last, the compare and contrast. Vocabulary. In vocabulary, students learn, practice, and decipher new vocabulary in text. Next is reflection. In reflection, students reflect on what they learn not only to themselves but with an audience to hear different ideas. Next, summarization. In summarization, students authentically recognize the main idea and details of an article and share them with an audience. Next, supporting claims. In supporting claims, students use evidence from text to support their thoughts. Next is fact check. In fact check, students use strategies to check the validity of sources. Next is compare and contrast. While in compare and contrast, students compare and contrast both text and perspective. That's all. Thank you for lending your time to watch and listen in my video report.